and this here may be tough. Do you snack cake to me? Yeah, more hostess.
More hostess.
This been overdue forever. Asked me when it was dropping, said never.
Never.
Should've made you cut the feather, but I designed it Freemason Margiela.
What's good, it's Shellitronnn here, the most woke, no joking. I'm back at again with a brand new video and won't bluff. Part of this video was inspired by a post on Reddit that I saw on the Panthers subreddit by a user by the name of, I think, BB1496. And he wanted to make a point about why quarterbacks' rush yards have been devalued over the years, and making a point specifically more about Cam Newton. I'll have a link to his post in the description below. You can check that out. And while he only covered total yards and touchdowns, I felt like this topic needed a little bit more depth and a little bit more context than just those two counting stats. So I went a little deeper than that. Now, I know most of you guys are Panthers fans, and so you're a little bit more receptive to this idea, but I want to let you know, I'm not being a homer when I say this. I'm talking about, this is backed up by statistics, and more than just one, more than two, more than three different statistics, this can be backed up and basically solidified. And there's people who aren't fans of the Panthers watching this video. Stay with me, keep an open mind, and you'll see that Cam Newton basically has always been a top five quarterback, or at this moment is a top five quarterback since 2011 when he joined the league. So throw this picture right here. Total quarterback yards since 2011. You see Drew Brees is number one at 35,436. You see Matt Stafford is number two, 32,777. Matt Ryan is number three, 32,483. Tom Brady has 31,776. You'll notice he plays for the Patriots, and the last four numbers in his total yards is 1776. And you might have, that might bring up three questions for you. Is this a conspiracy? Is it possible tampering? Should Tom Brady be suspended for four games? The answer to all three of those is yes. You see Philip Rivers in fifth place with 30,998 yards. Cam is in sixth all since 2011 with 29,394. Eli Manning has 29,226. Ben Roethlisberger has 28,941. Aaron Rodgers is in ninth place since 2011 with 27,523 total yards. And Andy Dalton is in 10th with 26,583. And then we can go to total quarterback touchdowns. You'll see Drew Brees is still in first with 264. Aaron Rodgers, no surprise here. He was low on the list of yards, but number two in touchdowns with 238. Tom Brady has 237. And Cam Newton, since 2011, has 212 total touchdowns, number four in the seven-year span. Matt Stafford has 208. Philip Rivers has 207. Matt Ryan, 197. Ben Roethlisberger, 187. Eli Manning at 186. And Andy Dalton at 185. And I found it kind of interesting that the quarterbacks with the most yards also were the same 10 quarterbacks with the most touchdowns. You would think that maybe Russell Wilson, or maybe even someone like Andrew Luck, even though he's been like plagued with injuries, may have gotten in that mix as well. Maybe Joe Flacco, he's been in the conversation for a while. But no, it's the same 10 quarterbacks for yards and touchdowns. So Cam Newton has been sixth since 2011 in total yards and fourth in total touchdowns for quarterbacks. You can't tell me you expected that. Then we have to go to two different other stats. Now you'll see that I kept this in the same order as the total quarterback touchdowns because it's really hard. You need a lot more context to really discuss playoff performance. Because you'll see here, Tom Brady obviously is number one with 13-5 in the playoffs. And Andy Dalton is obviously last with him being 0-5 in the playoffs. And obviously you have Matt Stafford at 0-3. But you have to also take into account, there's a lot of context here because just by record, you would say that Eli Manning should be number two on this list, right? I mean, he went 4-1 as a Super Bowl ring to his name, right? Well, that's kind of hard to say because if we look at it, if we go a little deeper into these stats, Eli Manning missed the playoffs. What was it? He only made the playoffs twice in this seven-year span. Does he deserve to be higher on the list with a 4-1 record? So it's a little hard to put this into perspective. And you see Philip Rivers has a 1-1 record in the playoffs. So, I mean, 1-1 is really good. But when you've only made the playoffs 1 year in the last seven, I mean, you can't. Am I going to put a 1-1 record above a 3-4 record? Because it's even and it's not negative. But you only made the playoffs 1 year out of the last seven. It's kind of hard to think about that. Like, you see Andy Dalton's 0-5. The Bengals can make it to the playoffs. The Bengals can make it to a playoffs in a pretty, you know, it's a pretty tough, it's a pretty tough little division they have there. They have the Ravens, who are, they're not great, but they're always pretty competitive. And the Steelers, who have one of the best rosters in the league. And basically, when you think AFC, you think Patriots, Steelers. So in that kind of division, Andy Dalton making it to the playoffs is kind of an achievement in itself. But you also have to think about, okay, maybe he can't get over the hump, but Andy Dalton being number 10 in both touchdowns and yards, but not having a win on his playoff record, is that more about him or more about Marvin Lewis? I'm not really sure if it's been, what is it, 13 or is it 17? I'm not sure how many years it's actually been where Marvin Lewis has been the coach there in Cincinnati, but he does not get wins in the playoffs. He does not get win in the playoffs. So it's kind of hard to actually think about playoff performance. We talk about these quarterbacks. And this is the really surprising thing. You know how people talk about how Cam is inaccurate and Cam throws a lot of interceptions? Well, according to this graphic, he's sixth. You have Aaron Rodgers at 46, Tom Brady at 57, number two. Ben Roethlisberger has 88 interceptions in the last 7 years. Matt Ryan has 92. Andy Dalton only is at number five with only 93 interceptions in the last 7 years. Cam is number six with 94 interceptions. Drew Brees has 96. Matt Stafford has 97. Phillip Rivers is number 9 with 108, and Eli Manning is number 10 with 115 interceptions since 2011. What this really tells me is that even though Cam is inaccurate, and we can all agree he's pretty inaccurate, he has a QBR of what, 57.5, and his accuracy over the last 7 years has been 58%, basically. He's not a very accurate quarterback. But, I mean, with these other players in the league, since he's been in the NFL, he's only ranked number 6 among players like Rodgers, Brady, Roethlisberger. He has less interceptions than Drew Brees, Matt Stafford, Phillip Rivers, and we already know about Eli Manning being a turnover machine. But, yes, for him to be 6th on this list and really only two interceptions away from being number 4 and tied with Matt Ryan, who people always put in the conversation as being just a step under elite. We have to ask ourselves, is Cam actually as bad of a quarterback as these guys, as these people who are in the news and in these sports outlets say he is? Or are they actually just using and cherry-picking stats they want to use that uplift other quarterbacks while ignoring Cam's strengths? Because I honestly believe, look, accuracy is a great stat. Like, people like Drew Brees who are throwing the rock down the field all the time. He has great accuracy. He can throw it from any level, and he can do pretty well. But players like Alex Smith for a few years there, and especially Tyrod Taylor, they can have high accuracy numbers, but if they're checking down half the time, then is that really valuable accuracy? If Cam was checking down a lot more, which he could be doing, he'd have a much higher accuracy than he does. But at that point, we have to add context to completion rate. I mean, QBR speaks for itself. You're not gonna see me arguing about Cam's QBR. But it seems like people take rush yards away from Cam when as if running the ball is a detriment to his skill set. And if we're talking about rush yards, Cam will be first by a much larger margin than these guys are in first to him in these other throwing stats. Like, Cam being fourth in total touchdowns, sixth in total yards, and sixth in total interceptions, he would be by far, there'd be a much bigger gap in his rush stats than Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady, Big Ben, Matt Ryan. So to use these different stats against Cam, but never speak on Cam's strengths and how far and away better he is at his strengths than these other elite quarterbacks is kind of a way of controlling the narrative of calling Cam a bad quarterback when he really has been and is a top 5 quarterback in this league. I didn't prepare a graphic for a rush yards because there's literally no reason. There's no reason. Cam has 4,300 rush yards in the past 7 years. I doubt there's a quarterback with even 1,000. I mean, there might be, but no one has 2,000. So there's no real reason for me to do that. If we talk about rush touchdowns, there's no need for me to do that either. Just judging off of his rankings in total yards, total touchdowns, total interceptions being so low, and then if we even talk about his total rush yards, total rush touchdowns, we could really get into talking about just where he ranks among great quarterbacks. But maybe I'm wrong. Let me know. Do you think Cam Newton is a top five quarterback in the league? Share this video so other people who aren't Panthers fans can weigh in on this. Is he a top five quarterback? Where would you rank him? And does his value as a runner take away from his ability as a quarterback, or does it add value as a quarterback? And why do you think rushing quarterbacks are looked so down upon and their rush statistics are always so like poo-pooed? It's like, yeah, he rushes, but look at his accuracy. Or yeah, he dominates on the ground, but look at his QBR. Let me know in the comments below, man. And you already know to do that like button.
Cheers to you, appreciate the chance. Being told y'all I've been the man. Being told y'all I had the gift. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Real ones gonna recommend. Count this as another win.